Hello everyone, it's Old Guardian here. In this Hearthstone Mercenaries video, I want to take a bit of a big perspective view on Hearthstone Mercenaries PvP and what we can expect from a mature Hearthstone Mercenaries PvP environment, what sort of meta should we be expecting. And as I'm recording this video, the Chess World Championship is underway, and that really made me think about how Hearthstone Mercenaries PvP compares to chess, and I think there are quite a lot of similarities. Obviously, there are differences. Chess is a game of perfect information. Mercenaries is not. Chess is also a game with no random elements, and there are random elements in Mercenaries, with speed ties, with targeting. So obviously there are differences. But the grand idea of how a game progresses through various stages, I think, is remarkably similar. Because, come to think about it, in Hearthstone Mercenaries game, we can think of opening as one stage of the game. Both players put three mercenaries on the board, and the interactions between these three mercenaries on both sides of the board can be calculated to a large extent. So in a similar fashion as in chess, there are various openings, we could also have opening theory in Hearthstone Mercenaries, which would dictate, like, what are you targeting? What are you going to do in response to seeing three specific mercenaries on the other side of the board? And we could also come to a position where we would know the optimal ways that our opponent is supposed to act, and should our opponent deviate from those ways, then we could find ways to punish them. So then the opening trio of mercenaries that you put on the board is kind of like choosing the opening in chess. Are you an e4 player? Are you a d4 player? What are you going to play in response? Are you going to play for Queen's Gambit? Going for Caro-Kann? Going for Sicilian, all of these lines, and then there's a bunch of theory on how the game is going to progress through the first few turns. And the same in Mercenaries. How is the game going to progress when you have an opening of three mercenaries versus three mercenaries? And at this point, we are very, very far away from this. For example, there was recently a discussion on the Mercenaries Discord about opening with Nature, Samurai, Mirror. The currently accepted truth is that you're targeting the opponent's Malfurion. But there have also been people who have been experimenting with targeting the opponent's Samuro and having good results with that. So pretty much the only thing that has been ruled out is kind of like trying to target their Brukan. That just doesn't seem to work. But with one of the most popular comps in the game, and mirror match of that comp, and the first turns are not solved at this point. So that kind of goes to show how far we are from really completing an opening theory for mercenaries. And then, just like in chess, we arrive to the mid-game. We are at the point, okay, where things start to happen. Players run out of their prep, and now it's about creativity, it's about calculation. And the same applies to mercenaries in some ways. You bring mercenaries off the bench, you might have surprises there, you might have counters. There are different scenarios, different environments. So we have this mid-game where your creativity and your calculation skills start to determine your result, instead of the pre-learned opening theory. And then from that mid-game, unless one of the players is really getting destroyed, we arrive to some kind of an end-game, with very few mercenaries left on the board, nothing left on the bench. What's going to happen then? Again, we arrive to a position that can be calculated to an extent, just like a chess end-game can be calculated. Are we in a rook end-game? Are we in a bishop-knight end-game? We know what's going to happen in these if they're properly played. And the same with mercenaries. Let's say we're in a Diablo versus Diablo end-game. A real situation that happened in the Mercenaries tournament, and there was a lot of discussion, okay, should there have been attack, should there have just been other ability uses, what were the right moves for the Diablos to fight, and what would be the results, and actually some people even tried to simulate it afterwards to see what were the correct actions to be taken in order to win that Diablo versus Diablo endgame. So in a mature Hearthstone Mercenaries PvP environment, I think we would come to a similar position as in chess. We would have this opening theory that dictates the first moves, then we would have the mid game that would be more creative, and then we would run into an end game, which again is more about something that can be calculated already in advance. But I think that would be a pretty fascinating game to play, albeit one that would of course also require tons and tons of theory and studying. So I guess the big question is, are we ever going to get there? Even for a game like Hearthstone, we have never gotten to a place where the competitive, the esports sides of the game would be really serious. I did a lot of analysis of Hearthstone esports some years ago, and the players have been improving, but the use of calculation in Hearthstone esports is minuscule. There would be tons of things that all the players there could still improve a lot, and it doesn't really attract the best talent. But the reason for that is fairly simple, because no matter how much you calculate, how much you improve, in a game like Hearthstone, the edge that you gain is so small. Even though you were the best player in the world, that would not guarantee a single win in a tournament. And the improvement in odds that you can generate is also too small to really validate the effort. So Hearthstone never got there. But what about Mercenaries? Mercenaries is less random than Hearthstone, so there's more room for skill to matter. But as of right now, I don't actually expect Mercenaries PvP to ever mature properly. And there are multiple reasons to this. The scene at the moment is very small, so there's not worth the effort. And because the scene is small, then there's limited innovation, there's limited analysis, it's just not worth the effort doing all that analysis, and the scene is unlikely to grow because there's huge barriers to entry into proper Mercenaries PvP, because maxed mercs are really important for that, and maxed mercs are outside of the reach of 99% of the player base, within any reasonable time frame anyway. So I guess this analysis kind of ends on a bleak note, because I think there's so much potential in Mercenaries, and this sort of opening, mid-game, end-game, proper opening theory, proper end-game theory, that would be a very fascinating environment to play PvP in, but I don't think we're going to get there because the benefit of putting in all of that work just doesn't exist. But if by any chance you happen to want to improve your Mercenaries PvP skills, then this sort of framework of thinking about the progress of a Mercenaries match might prove to be useful. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the content, please click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and check out my Twitch channel.